Now that you understand the power of search, it's time to think about Google Display Ads. People show a high purchase intent when they search for your product or service, which is why it's important that your ad shows up. But 96% of time spent online happens outside of search, across websites, on YouTube, in Gmail, or in mobile apps. So how do you reach these potential customers across Google properties? Google Display Ads can help you reach 90% of global internet users at all points in the buying cycle, from discovery to purchase. This is done with powerful machine learning technology that utilizes user signals to ensure you reach the right potential customers. When thinking about reaching the right audiences, there are two complementary strategies you should consider. The first is re-engage. This strategy allows you to serve relevant, powerful messages to people who have already engaged with your business. For example, offering a deal to people who have visited your website or reminding people about a product or service they were interested in. The second strategy you should consider is expand. Expanding allows you to reach new qualified customers that you've never connected with before. For example, if you're selling kids' shoes, you might want to show ads to parents or, more specifically, to people who are actively looking to buy children's apparel. Google Ads offers a variety of audience types, but in this video, we'll focus on two types of audiences: remarketing, which falls under the re-engage strategy, and custom intent, which falls under the expand strategy. Let's first discuss remarketing. In order to show your ads to people who interacted with your website or mobile app, you need to first implement the Google Ads tag and build remarketing lists. The remarketing global site tag and event snippets are blocks of code that add your website visitors to remarketing lists. This allows you to show your ads to previous visitors. Let's get started. Go to Tools, and under the Shared Library, click Audience Manager. Go to Audience Sources and choose Google Ads Tag. Click on Tag Setup. Now choose if you want to implement the tag yourself, email the tag to someone else, like your website admin, or implement it through Google Tag Manager. All three options have clear instructions on how to implement the tag. After you implement your tag successfully, you will see some lists that are automatically created. You'll see an All Visitors list of everyone who has visited your website, an All Converters list, or a Google Ads Optimized list that combines audiences from multiple sources into a single remarketing list. You can also create your own list. For example, you can create a list of people who have visited a specific product page or a list of people who abandoned their shopping cart. Let's say you're selling kids' clothes and you want to show a special offer to everyone who has visited your onesies page. This can be set up easily if your onesies page has a unique URL that contains a word like onesies or any other unique expression. In the Audience Manager, choose Audience Lists and click the plus button. For this example, let's create a website visitors list. Give your audience a clear name. There are several types of rules that you can define a list with. For this example, we're creating a list with visitors of a page. Define the URL rule for your specific list. In this case, we want to use a URL that contains the word onesies. You can also define a rule for a URL that starts or ends with a word, or a URL that doesn't contain a certain word. You can then define a membership duration for your list. The default is 30 days, but it can be changed to any time between 1 day to 540 days. You should choose a membership duration based on how long it takes people to convert, from the moment they first visit your website to the time they make a purchase. For example, people who are browsing for shampoo might purchase shortly after researching, in comparison to people who are interested in buying auto insurance. Now click Create Audience. You'll see your list on the Audience List tab. Now let's implement the list in your campaign. In your account, click Display Campaigns, and then click Audiences. Click the pencil icon, then select Edit Ad Group Targeting. Select an ad group. Make sure to select a new ad group that doesn't have existing audiences assigned to it, since it's not recommended to layer audiences. Under Targeting, select Narrow Targeting. Select Audiences, and then click the pencil icon next to Target Audiences. Click Browse and select Remarketing and Similar Audiences. You'll be able to find your list under Website Visitors. Select it and scroll down to Settings. At this stage, you can decide if you want to increase your reach to users with similar profiles and by how much. Base your decision on the weekly estimates while moving the toggle. Click Save. Let's now discuss custom intent as part of your expand strategy. Think about this. 7 Google properties reach over 1 billion people monthly. Signals from all of these properties help qualify an audience who is actively shopping with intent to purchase. Custom intent is a unique audience list you can create based on keywords and landing pages that you define in order to reach a highly qualified audience. Sometimes new advertisers don't have enough website visitors to run remarketing campaigns. If that's the case, you can start with custom intent by expanding to new customers and then later re-engage with potential customers who have already visited your website. Let's create a custom intent audience. Go to your display campaigns and follow the same steps as remarketing, but after you get to the targeted audience option, choose In Market and Custom Intent. Click the blue plus icon next to New Custom Intent Audience. Create a name for your custom intent audience and add any related keywords or URLs that this audience might be actively researching. It's recommended to add about 15 keywords or URLs to help the system better understand your audience. Keywords are considered broad match, so there's no need to include plurals or misspellings. After you enter your keywords and URLs, you can view suggested auto-created segments on the right under Ideas. Add whatever is relevant. Under Audience Size, you can preview the estimated reach and demographic information of your custom intent audience. Click Create, and now scroll down to Settings. You'll be able to control how far you want to expand your defined audience. Now click Save. These two types of audience strategies are complementary. You can grow your audience and reach new people while helping existing audiences finalize their conversion. Now that you understand the reach of display, let's wrap up your learnings with a Google Ads success checklist.